K-Ball here from ZURB. In today's lesson, we are going to be introducing you to CSS Grid. CSS Grid is an awesome new spec that's come out that really solves a lot of age-old problems with laying out elements in the browser. It just recently got released in the latest version of Firefox and the latest version of Chrome, so this is ready for you to play around with and try it out. For today's lesson, we're going to be playing with CSS Grid to make a McGriddle layout. We'll be laying things out in a grid to create a replica of a McGriddle sandwich. It should be a lot of fun, so let's check it out. All right, so let's get started. To begin with, you're going to want to have a browser that is CSS Grid capable. I'm using the latest Chrome, Chrome 57. You can also use the latest Firefox, Firefox 52. Or if you want to... you could use IE 10, 11, or Edge. They all ship with some level of CSS support, but they have a prefix, and we're not going to be using the prefix for this lesson, so if you're doing that, you'll need to modify slightly. I recommend Chrome or Firefox. So we'll start with Chrome. This is where I am, and what we're going to be creating is a McGriddle sandwich using a grid as a sort of metaphor, because we love puns over here, for creating a grid layout. So we're going to start by just creating a little bit of markup. So get our structure in place. So we'll start with a class griddle and just have that be our outer class. And then inside of that, we're gonna have sort of a top cake on top of it and a bottom cake. These are kind of gonna go inside around our content. And then in the middle, we're gonna have some sort of a fillings in there. So let's create a div for our fillings. And I don't know about you, but I like to have, you know, everything in there. So we're going to have some cheese. We're going to have some sausage. And we're going to have at the bottom have some egg in there. Cheese, sausage, and egg, cake on top and bottom. This should be delicious, right? Okay, so we have our structure, but so far nothing's showing because we're not actually putting anything in there. So that's obvious. We gotta actually style this thing for it to show up. Though if we were to look at this, you know, all of our divs are now in place, we'll be able to stick with that structure pretty much throughout. So first off, let's give the griddle itself some sort of height. So let's give, we're going to start with griddle, and you know what, I'm going to change this from CSS to SAS because it's just easier to deal with. So we'll start, we'll give our griddle a height of 100 VH, the whole height of the browser, and we're going to use display grid. Display grid is the new display property, and what this is doing is saying that our griddle is a grid parent. And we want to prep our grid to handle all the different rows and columns we might have in this. So let's think. The way that we want our McGriddle to behave is we want to keep our cake buns stepped to the top and the bottom, and the fillings are going to be in the center and sort of widen and narrow depending on the window's width and kind of take up any additional space height-wise as the thing goes. So we'll be using two properties to handle this. We'll use grid template rows and grid template columns, and these basically lay out the number of rows and columns for our grid. And so let's do that. So we're going to use grid template rows. We know that we have two fixed cake buns and a growing middle area. So we can do that by using the a fun unit called 1FR, which is a fraction of the remaining space. So we can make our fixed cakes 100 pixels on top, 1FR, or one fraction of the remaining space in the middle, and 100 pixels on the bottom. And if we actually give these things some background colors, let's do that real quick so we can see what's gonna happen there. Or we'll get to that, but what this is doing is the top is getting 100 pixels, and then we're gonna have some stuff in the middle, and the bottom is gonna be 100 pixels. And you know what we can do here is actually, let's start putting some background colors on these divs so that we can actually see what they look like. So let's start with putting something on the cake. We'll give it a background color. Let's see, some sort of nice light cake-like color. So let's do E in E-base. So we'll do background color.
EDCF9F. I know that's a nice little cake color. And then let's give the center part, the fillings, another color. So we'll make our fillings. Where's the, what's a good color for that? Fillings. Let's use background color. F6A623. So we can already actually see that these rows that we talked about are coming into play. So all we did is set the grid template rows, and it's already laying out these divs in those rows. So we've got 100 pixels at the top, whatever the remaining area is, and then 100 pixels at the bottom. And if we resize this, that is shifting as we would expect. So that's pretty cool. We just have three lines of CSS, and we're already starting to get a really great grid style. Let's also talk about columns. So column-wise, you know, you kind of want the cakes to be wider than the fillings. So we're going to want to do something similar to what we did with the rows here. So let's take our columns, and we can do the same thing of creating a template for the columns. Let's do grid template columns. 120 pixels, make it a little different. 1FR, 120 pixels. And by default, what we're seeing is now that we've added columns, our items are actually filling out in the columns first. And if we were to add more, say we added another item of cake, it's going to keep layering on as we go. So by default, every div here, every direct child of our grid element is taking up one row column connection. We don't really want that, right? We want our cake to span the top. We want our cake, our filling to be in the middle. We want our other cake to be on the bottom. So the way we can do this is first we can specify how many rows we want to do. So how wide are the buns, the cakes? So what we can do with that is we can define the start point. And we're going to start, in this case, on one. And we want to do, where is it going to end? We want it to end all the way past column three to the start of column four. So one really tricky thing to get your head around if you're used to thinking of the foundation grid thinks in terms of the columns and doesn't really think about the gutters. But with CSS grid, it actually thinks about the gaps between the columns as lines. So we're starting at line one. Line one is over here to the very left. We're going to span some number of columns, and then we're going to end at another line. So in this case, the line we want to end at is not one, not two, not even three. We want to go all the way to four. So our grid column end is going to be four. We look at that, and we're already starting to see that structure where here we go. We've got a cake. It's spanning all the columns. We have some fillings. Now, they're still only by default setting up one column, and the cake on the bottom is once again spanning all of the columns. So if we want to get the fillings in place, we can do something similar. Let's actually expose another fun thing. So we want the cake to actually start on line number two. So we're going to do grid column start two. And by default, it will just span that one. You can actually do grid column end span one, and so you can tell it how many to span. You don't have to worry about the calculations. So we're already starting to see that structure coming into place with just a few things. And what if you look at what this does, this really enables us to think in two dimensions in a whole new way, right? We've got items that are pretty flat, and we can start laying out all sorts of fun and fancy things with cheese and sausage and egg, and we'll leave that as an exercise for you to do. But with a few simple lines of CSS, no structure, no additional non-semantic classes, nothing like that, we are creating a whole two-dimensional layout.
All right, so that's it for today's lesson. You've just learned an introduction to CSS Grid and made an awesome McGriddle sandwich. We think CSS Grid is super awesome and is really going to take Foundation to the next level. We've been doing all sorts of different experiments, and we just published a whole set of them. So check out the link below to see some of the possibilities enabled by CSS Grid. Also, if you enjoyed this lesson, we publish a new one every week, so you can hit subscribe right up there to get it automatically. Every new subscriber in the Yeti will get a McGriddle! Hope to see you next time!